Amitriptyline is the name of an antidepressant drug that we use to treat some types of chronic pain, like fibromyalgia and neuropathic pain. In this video, I will answer 10 common questions that people ask me about amitriptyline. Number 1. How amitriptyline works for pain? Will amitriptyline help me to sleep? Is there any contraindication to take amitriptyline? 4. Can amitriptyline cause weight gain? What to do when amitriptyline doesn't work for my pain? Does amitriptyline cause any damage to the liver or kidneys? Can you use amitriptyline during pregnancy and breastfeeding? Can you drive or can you take alcohol with amitriptyline? Is amitriptyline good for anxiety? Is amitriptyline addictive? So let's talk about amitriptyline today. How does amitriptyline work? Amitriptyline was one of the very first medications developed to treat depression in the 1960s. It increases serotonin and norepinephrine in the synapses by blocking the enzymes that remove these neurotransmitters. So if you block the removal of serotonin and norepinephrine, there will be more of them available for a long time. Well, serotonin and norepinephrine are neurotransmitters that regulate mood. They are also important in the descending pain pathways. In theory, if you can have more serotonin and norepinephrine in the brain, the mood is better and your brain will be able to block pain sensations that are coming from the periphery. However, the scientific evidence from randomized controlled trials of amitriptyline for pain is not too convincing. The two most recent Cochrane reviews of amitriptyline for pain in adults concluded that amitriptyline has been a first-line treatment for fibromyalgia for many years. The fact that there is no supportive and biased evidence for a beneficial effect is disappointing, but has to be balanced against years of successful treatment in many patients with fibromyalgia. There is no good evidence of a lack of effect. Rather, their concern should be of overestimation of treatment effect. Amitriptyline will be one option in the treatment of fibromyalgia, while recognizing that only a minority of patients will achieve satisfactory pain relief. It's unlikely that any large randomized trials of amitriptyline will be conducted in fibromyalgia to establish efficacy statistically or measure the size of the effect. And very similar conclusions for neuropathic pain. Amitriptyline has been a first-line treatment for neuropathic pain for many years. The fact that there is no supportive and biased evidence for a beneficial effect is disappointing, but has to be balanced against decades of successful treatment in many people with neuropathic pain. There is no good evidence of lack of effect. Rather than the concerns of the authors of this review, is that it should be some overestimation of treatment effect. Amitriptyline should continue to be used as part of the treatment of neuropathic pain, but only a minority of people will achieve satisfactory pain relief. There is limited information that suggests failure with one antidepressant does not mean failure with all. And we know that the pain relief effect is independent from the antidepressant effect. This is to say that some people may improve mood and not pain. Other people may improve pain and not mood. Others will improve both, and some will improve none. Before I continue, let me remind you that this video is not intended to replace medical advice. It is for educational purposes only. You should contact your doctor for a proper diagnosis and treatment plan for you. And in case of emergency, go to the nearest emergency department or call an ambulance. Question 2. Will amitriptyline help me to sleep? It is quite possible that you will sleep faster, longer, and better with amitriptyline. In many patients with chronic pain, this is a good side effect as they don't sleep well. In patients with myofascial pain syndrome, this side effect is quite useful because patients need to relax their muscles at night, and amitriptyline will help them to achieve this goal. However, the side effect is what makes some people to stop amitriptyline as they can't get up from bed in the morning. They say that they are too fatigued and groggy in the morning. In this case, I tell them to take the amitriptyline earlier in the evening, maybe 2 hours before their bedtime. This usually helps them to feel more alert when they wake up. Question 3. Is there any contraindication or precautions to take amitriptyline? Yes. Amitriptyline may cause a condition that affects the heart rhythm, including in people with QT prolongation. Amitriptyline may make you more sensitive to the sun. You have to limit your time in the sun, avoid tanning booths or sun lamps, use sunscreen and wear protective clothing when outdoors. Older adults may be more sensitive to the side effects of this drug, especially dry mouth, dizziness, drowsiness, confusion, constipation, difficulty urinating, and QT prolongation. They may also have an increased risk of falling. People with glaucoma, narrow-angle glaucoma, should not take amitriptyline. And men with prostate hypertrophy should be careful, as it may cause urinary retention. People with bipolar depression should not take amitriptyline because it may precipitate hypomanic episodes. People who use a MAO inhibitor should not take amitriptyline. It should also not be given to people with a history of epilepsy or seizures because it decreases the threshold for seizures. Number 4. Can amitriptyline cause weight gain? Yes, that is a common side effect of amitriptyline because it increases appetite. On average, people may gain 5 to 10 pounds, but the good news is that they lose those pounds when they stop the medication. 5. What to do when amitriptyline doesn't work for my pain? It might be that the dose you were taking is not high enough, or you didn't try for longer enough, or you're not taking every day. For amitriptyline to work, the person needs to take it every day for at least 2 months. If they tried a few days here and there, they would not notice any benefits, either for depression or pain. For depression, they may start to feel better after 1 to 2 weeks, but it can take 4 to 6 weeks for amitriptyline to work fully. For pain, they may notice some benefits after 4 weeks. The dose for depression is usually higher than the dose for pain. We start with 10 milligrams at night, then increase slowly every 2 weeks, then we increase to 20 milligrams, 50, 75. We stop at 75 for pain management. For depression, the person may need to go up to 150 milligrams per day. Most people stop taking amitriptyline because of the side effects. The most common are dry mouth, constipation, fatigue, weight gain, orthostatic hypotension, which is a drop in the blood pressure when you go from sitting to standing position. You may feel dizzy for a few seconds and fall. Number 6. Does amitriptyline cause any damage to the liver or kidneys? We are usually not concerned that this drug will be toxic to the liver or kidneys, even if the person will have to use it for the rest of their lives. But it is important to know before we give the first prescription if the person has any liver or kidney function problem, because we may need to reduce the dose. Number 7. Can you use amitriptyline during pregnancy and breastfeeding? Well, during pregnancy, this medication should be used only when clearly needed. And since untreated depression and anxiety can be a serious condition, do not stop using amitriptyline during pregnancy unless directed by your doctor. If you're planning to become pregnant or think you may be pregnant, immediately discuss this with your doctor about the benefits and risks of using this medication during pregnancy. This medication passes into the breast milk and the effects of a nursing infant is unknown, so it's better to consult your doctor before breastfeeding. Number 8. Can you drive or can you take alcohol with amitriptyline? The short answer is no. If you feel that you are dizzy and sleepy, you should not be driving a car or operating any heavy equipment. You could cause injury to yourself and others. And taking it with alcohol makes you sleepier and dizzier. Is amitriptyline good for anxiety? Amitriptyline has sedating and anti-anxiety effects, and those can be helpful to people who suffer from anxiety disorders, especially anxiety that is on top of depression. However, it's important to remember that if you stop taking your daily amitriptyline, your body will have withdrawal symptoms. And those abstinence symptoms may include nausea, anxiety, insomnia, and headaches. And last question, is amitriptyline addictive? There is no such thing as addiction to amitriptyline. Physical dependence is not the same thing as being addicted. It is expected that the person will develop some physical dependence if they use antidepressants every day for a long period. The same way that people can develop physical dependence to thyroid hormones and blood pressure medications. If they stop any of those medications abruptly, they have withdrawal symptoms. It doesn't mean that they are addicted to their thyroid hormones or blood pressure medications. When the person uses amitriptyline for a prolonged time, they cannot stop abruptly. They need to reduce the dose slowly, and this will avoid the withdrawal symptoms. And there are people who abuse amitriptyline, and that's mainly because of these sedative effects. Overdose of amitriptyline is a very serious condition. It doesn't mean that the person is addicted to it. People may also abuse acetaminophen, ibuprofen, or steroids. The person needs education that they cannot increase the dose too quickly. So I hope that this answered your 10 top questions about amitriptyline. And if you like this video, press the thumbs up button here. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and turn on the notifications button. And watch my next video here. Goodbye!